It's something to be blessed.
Hallelujah.
He said, blessed in the city, blessed in the field, blessed when you come and when you go. Sometimes you're just going to be blessed all the time. Hallelujah. And that's important. You got to receive the blessings of God. You got to receive the forgiveness of God. Hallelujah. Late in the midnight hour. And nobody else is up.
Can you praise
quietly or is it loud? Can you just gently wave your hand, or would it be a more exuberant wave? Is it an internal personal thing, or is it an outward expression? Let's look at how it's defined. Praise to express a favorable judgment of or commend. When you praise a child, you speak to them. You tell them, good job, or that was great. You're excited, you smile. They can feel your praise even through your words. Another definition says to glorify a god or saint, especially by the attribution of perfections. So when we say praise God, we're not talking about a god. We're talking about the God, the one who created, I'll make it simple, everything.
Everything.
In its original language, the word praise meant to be boastful, shout both in joy and in sorrow. It meant to brag on God. If the God of heaven and earth is Lord over your life, and knowing all that he's done and is doing, don't you think he deserves to be boasted about, to be bragged on? My goodness, we will brag on our favorite sports teams, wear their colors, spend big money on team jerseys, shoes, t-shirts, jackets, hats, keychains, posters, cups, and anything else they can put a logo on. Now, watch this. When you consider the heavens and the earth, God's logo is on everything. And guess what? It doesn't cost you anything.
All right.
To see God's handiwork is absolutely free, and we see it every day.
Amen.
But do we praise him every day? Do we cheer for him every day?
Yes.
Did any of you in here ever try out for the cheerleading squad in high school? We haven't. And see, it was the cheer squad was male and female. Well, I did. And when I was in high school, not everybody who tried out made the squad.
All right. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. There were some minimum requirements you had to meet. There were some gymnastic moves you needed to be able to perform. And it was a competition. Back then, they didn't worry about bruising your ego. They didn't worry about scarring your psyche. You either made the squad or you were cut. But now you can be a cheerleader every day and you don't even have to try out for the squad. No one is going to tell you you're not good enough for the squad. There's no minimum requirement. There's no requirement to perform a gymnastic move. You don't have to be able to do the splits or a round off or any of that stuff. When you accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, you're on the squad. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Though, there's those words again. You're on the team. So, how many in here have accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior?
Amen.
You see him?
Amen.
Okay, amen. Okay, okay, good. So, you're on the cheer squad. We're going to do a quick cheer. Okay, you with me? Okay, it goes like this. I'm going to say, give me up, and you say, I'm going to, and I'll call out a letter, and you'll respond with, you got your, whatever that letter is, you got your, and that letter. For instance, I say, give me an A, you say, you got your A, you got your A, and I say, you know, give me a, all right, y'all ready?
Amen.
Now, we cheer, so I need y'all to get out, all right?
Okay.
All right, here we go. Give me a J!
Yeah.
thank you. That's our cheerleading. That's what we need to be. We need to be excited about the Lord.
Amen.
We need to be excited about what He's doing in our lives. When we praise God, it's an outward expression. Now, where does this praising take place? Well, you can do it anywhere at any time, but in this particular scripture, we're talking about praising God in His sanctuary.
All right.
This is the sanctuary. When you come in here, you should come in here prepared to praise God on purpose.
Amen.
You might have to do something on purpose.
Intentional.
Intentional. He's an intentional God. We should be intentional about our praise. Come on, y'all.
Amen.
Amen.
Shout on purpose.
Yes.
Purpose in your heart. The woman with the issue of blood had a purpose. She had a mission. She was intentional about her need to touch the hem of His garment. When we come in here and we give God praise, we need to be intentional about the praise that we're going to give God. When you come in here, you should see God and your brother and sister and praise Him because you do. I shared in our Sunday school class, Sister Knight's mother walked in that door yesterday and she just opened her arms wide and I walked into her arms. She didn't say a word. She had a smile on her face. She had her arms open wide and it was just a beautiful invitation. That's what your brothers and sisters need to see in you. That beautiful invitation, that smile on your face that says, I'm a safe place. You can talk to me. I have something for you. I have Jesus. That's what they need to see. Praise Him in the firmament of His power. Praise Him because of His power and glory which appear in the firmament or the atmosphere. Its vastness, its brightness, and because of the powerful influences it has on this earth. We're not left to praise Him by ourselves. This verse invites those that have their dwelling in the firmament of His power, the holy angels, to lead in this good work. There are some who interpret this, the sanctuary and the firmament of His power, and understand it as the highest heavens, the residence of His glory. That is for sure His sanctuary, His holy temple, and in that place, He is praised continually. Way better than we can praise Him here. So we should take notes on how the angels praise Him. The angels in heaven continually cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty.
Yes.
And they cry, holy, 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 continually.
Yes.
That's all the time, y'all. Can we continually cry, holy, holy, holy?
Yes.
Praising God is not about how you feel. It's about who He is.
That's right.
It's not about what He has or hasn't done for you. It's about His mighty acts.
Mm-hmm. All right.
God put the sun in the sky at just the right distance so that it doesn't burn us up and we don't freeze. He made it so it lights our days, and He put the moon with its softer glow to light our nights. He gives us a cool breeze to cool us down when it's hot.
Yes.
He gives us air to breathe and water to drink. Mm-hmm. We're talking about His mighty acts.
Yes.
He didn't allow your grief to consume you when your loved one died. He kept you in your right mind when everything and it seemed everyone around you was going crazy. He kept His hand of mercy upon you as you went about your day. No one came into the place where you went to get a quick bite to eat or mail a package or your workplace or where you just walked around. No one came in with a gun and tried to shoot you. We're talking about His mighty acts. You see, His mighty acts are not just about what did happen. Sometimes it's about what didn't happen. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness.
Right.
Oh Lord, how excellent. For His surpassing greatness. There is nobody greater than the God we serve. And when you're on the winning team, that is praiseworthy, don't you think? There's an old song that says, God is great and greatly to be praised. Glory, glory to His name. God is great and greatly to be praised. Let the Lord, oh my soul.
Amen.
And now that we know where to praise him. Mm-hmm. We know we have some heavenly hosts to praise him with. Mm-hmm. We know why we praise him. Let's talk about how we praise him.
Come on now.
The scripture starts with a trumpet.
Yeah.
The trumpet has its own unique sound. The trumpet group contains the instruments with the highest register in the brass family. Yeah, I love this song to me, y'all. Trumpet-like instruments have historically been used as signaling devices in battle or hunting, with examples dating back to at least 1500 BC. It wasn't until the late 14th or early 15th century they began to be used as musical instruments. Trumpets are now used in art music styles like orchestras, concert bands, and jazz ensembles. If you have any knowledge of instruments, you know when you hear the trumpet sound. Yes. The next instrument is the psaltery or lute. This is a stringed instrument like a guitar. And in that same family, we have the harp. The psaltery and harp are played by touching them sharply, plucking, pulling, or twitching. And in the case of the strings of musical instruments, you play them with the fingers and not with a pick. The psaltery was originally made from wood and relied on natural acoustics for sound production. Then we get to my favorite. The timbre. The tambourine. That's what is known to us as today. It can be open or it can be covered. And you can use it not only to make sound with the cymbals, you can use it for percussion. The women of the Old Testament often used that as an accompaniment for dancing. Now, you may not have been gifted to play an instrument, but here's something that most of us can do, and as I look around the room, I think all of us can do this. We can dance for the Lord.
Well,
you don't have to know the latest line dance. You don't have to be in step with anybody else. No one has to lead you. This dance is your dance for the God of your salvation.
Amen.
After all the Lord's done for you, you just ought to be able to cut a step for him.
Amen. All right now. All right.
We got it? Now look.
Amen.
Excluding the children, how many of y'all ever been to a club?
Well.
Yeah. Look, tell the truth. All right. And you danced in the club, right?
Yes.
Amen. Then we ought to be able to dance for the Lord. Amen. Yeah. We don't get in the house of the Lord, backing that thing up, all right? We don't drop it like it's hot, but we can do a dance for the Lord, amen?
Amen.
And help us out that with that dance, praise God, we have the stringed instruments and the organs. When you have anointed musicians, they can help usher in the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
But they can't do it all by themselves. They can be up here, they can be playing, and they can be playing beautifully, and the anointing can be all over them, but you have a responsibility.
Come on now.
You have to enter into the house, into the sanctuary, with a ready praise on your lips, with a hallelujah, with a glory to God, with a praise the Lord. You have to come into the sanctuary with dancing in your feet, ready to cut a step for the Lord. You have to enter the sanctuary with clapping in your hands. Did anybody come into the house? Did you come into the sanctuary with a praise for God this morning? Did you, did you come with a praise for the Lord?
Amen.
Amen. That's why we're here. That's our whole purpose. It's not just to come in and listen to somebody stand up here in this place and preach to you. Amen. Some people feel like we're preaching at you, but we're trying to give you something that's going to save your life, that's going to get you from here to tomorrow, that's going to encourage you, that's going to admonish you, to reprove, to keep you where you need to be in right standing with God. Amen. That's why we come here, but our primary purpose, the main reason we're here, is to praise God.
Amen.
He gave us another day. He didn't have to let us wake up this morning. The old people said some people are on their coon in bed. That means the table at the morgue, y'all. We're not there. Praise God.
Amen.
And not only do we have our musicians on the string instruments, we have our drummer to give God praise on the cymbals.
Amen.
Amen. Now, you may not have found yourself in any of these areas of the scripture that has that we've talked about thus far, even though you are in the sanctuary, you are in the firmament of his power. You may not recognize his mighty acts. Perhaps you can't see his excellent greatness. Or you may not know how to play the trumpet, a lute, a guitar, or a tambourine. You may not be comfortable dancing. Or maybe you're hurt and you can't get up and dance. Maybe you don't know how to play a string instrument or the drums. But God never leaves any of his children out, so don't fret. In verse 6, it says, let
everything
that has breath praise the Lord.
Yes.
And just in case you didn't get it the first time, the psalmist repeats it. Praise ye the Lord.
Amen.
Now, I didn't see anybody being carried in here this morning in a box. They didn't roll anybody in and lay them out in front of them. Everybody's eyes were open when they came through those doors, so I'm going to take a small leap, and I'm going to believe that everybody in this room is breathing. I'm going to believe that everyone in this room has been delivered from something.
Amen.
I'm going to believe that everyone in this room has experienced God's grace.
Amen.
I'm going to believe that everyone in this room has experienced God's mercy.
Amen.
I'm going to believe that everyone in this room has something to praise God for.
Yes.
I'm going to believe that everyone in this room has a reason to thank God. I'm going to believe that everyone in this room has a reason to love God. And I'm going to believe that everyone in this room has something that they can praise God for. I'm going to believe these things because God's praise is not contingent upon your circumstances. I don't care what you're going through right now. God is still worthy of praise, glory, and honor. He's worthy of praise because he gave his only begotten son.
Come on now.
Jesus is worthy of praise because he took the beating.
Yes.
Because he took the scourging.
Uh-huh.
Because he carried his cross.
Yes.
Because he hung on that cross. Because he died for our sins. Because he conquered death, hell, and the grave so that we can have eternal life.
Yes.
So that we can live in heaven for eternity. You're going to live forever somewhere. You're going to be immortal somewhere. Now, where do you raise your eyes up when you lay down for your last time? Where you open your eyes is up to you. When you open them up in hell, where there's weeping and gnashing of teeth, or when you open them up in heaven, where there's the glory of the Lord. Which one?
Amen.
If you've never made that decision to accept Jesus as the Lord and Savior of your life,
yes.
Today is a great day.
Great day.
It's a great day.
Amen.
Tomorrow is not promised. It's not said to scare you, but tomorrow is not promised. We have today. We have right now. The doors of the church are open. Let us stand.